Hey guys, it's Blake, OGXbox.com. Just wanted to do an updated game room tour. So my wife has let me have a room dedicated to video games. And so I wanted to just kind of take you guys through what I've got in my collection so far. So just like to share it with people. I don't have a lot of people over, so nobody else really gets to enjoy this with me. So first, we'll start off over here with, this is kind of my Nintendo section. It's not as organized as I want it to be, but we have a boxed N64, just a regular one, at the top left, and then right next to it is the Daihawks. It was Japanese, and there's some big superstore over there. I can't remember what it was, and they've got a sports team, I guess, and it's in those colors. So that big superstore released the Daihawks version, and I put the Mario 64 up there just because there was a gap and that one kind of looked good over there. And then some of my favorite N64 games, I have very few, and then even fewer Super Nintendo, and then quite a few boxed original NES games. And then I don't know why, but my wife and I really like these Super Mario 2 cups. She collects Pyrex, and so, you know, in the stores where you might find that, you sometimes also find these Super Mario 2 glasses. So that's why that's there. And then an old kind of beat up copy of Mario 2 I just put behind it. Just I had it, and it kind of made that look nicer. You know, some Game Boy stuff to the right. She got me some Sonic air fresheners. Didn't know what to do with those, so they looked all right there. Master System, Saturn, I really don't have a lot of. Rarely ever play that. It's weird because I always wanted a Saturn when I was a kid, really bad, never had one. And now that I have one, I'm like, oh, good thing I never had one. I did have a Sega CD as a kid. I had that CDX. It's not that one right there. I actually traded the one I had as a kid for a Mountain Dew Xbox, the broken one that I have. I didn't know it was broken. I kind of got scammed on it. But it came in the box, so maybe not too bad. But I have quite a few Sega CD games. That Kyo Flying Squadron is arguably the most rare Sega CD game. I do not have a Snatcher, which is not really rare. it's priced like it is. It's really not. It's somewhat uncommon, but it's not rare. That game right there is kind of rare. And then get some Dreamcast. There's CDX, Genesis, Nomads. I was into the Nomad screen modding for a while, which is where I had leftover screens, and that's how I did the, you know, the portable Xbox. You know, just plug in screen. I know that screen kind of stinks, but it, you know, it was just kind of proof that it's possible. I can use a better screen later on. I just wanted to know that it works. And then I had a 32X as a kid, and I know the library sucks, but I was like, you know what? I can get the entire library. Let's just do it. So that is the entire North American library, CIB. So,
you know, there's the more expensive ones over there, the Spider-Man and the Pitfall and the World Series, Deion Sanders. Or is it RBI? I don't know. One of those is Deion Sanders. They suck, so who cares?
And there's the box 32X. Few complete. All these, if you see a box, it has the system in it and it's complete. Unless the system is sitting right on top of it, but yeah, no, I think all of them have the system inside. The Virtual Boy does not. The Wii, I couldn't get it. I couldn't get that reboxed, so it's just sitting there. And if you see a little container, a gum container like that, it's got little parts. So whenever I take anything apart, I put the screws or whatever in a container like that. Otherwise, it gets lost. You don't know where it went. So that's what I do there. I'm into PlayChoice 10s. There was three North American PlayChoice 10 systems. I have all three. I've restored them. I have almost every game for PlayChoice 10. I have Not all the toppers. I have a lot of the toppers though. And then there's more games in there. Two more of the arcade machines are in my basement. They can't come up here, and you'll see why, because this room's not very big. Here's my DOA Ultimate Kasumi Blue. I've got two of these. This is the one that was taken out of the box. It is mint, though. That's the controller for it, and it has. I have the box for it. It's in my closet, and I can show you that, but we're not there yet. Here's the. Oh, my. That's my concealed carry pistol. I carry that with me all the time. I did not mean for that to be in the shot. Yeah, sorry about that. So anyway, that's the X-Rocker chair. Probably the least comfortable chair that I own. I would not recommend that chair. Futon or whatever you got is much better. This thing was kind of expensive for what it is. It's hard as a rock. The speakers kind of suck. So yeah, don't get that. That Kasumi Blue Xbox there, that all of these contain the Xbox that goes with them. Okay, so that's like I said, the Kasumi Blue. That is complete. It has all the pack-in material. The next one is the second anniversary Pure White. That's complete. Everything that came with it originally is inside of it. The next one is the Panzer Dragoon Orta. The white one with the lettering. I've got that posted online. The next one is the, I think that's the Mountain Dew. And this in pictures that showed up, this looks like the box is messed up. It's not. That's actually the manual that's I wedged in between there. But one of these is the Mountain Dew, and it actually has, it's not complete, meaning that it doesn't have all the pack-in material and whatever controller came with it and all that. It probably could be. I probably have everything to put one together, but it didn't come that way. So the broken Mountain Dew, which is right there, it came with this box, and I had a complete, well, not complete, but I had a working Mountain Dew console that I just stuck in the box. It has the styrofoam and all that with it, but whatever. Then the other two are just, I think, no, one of them is a launch team, but the box does not match the launch team. I just had a bo another box, an empty box. I put the launch team inside of it. And then the one on the end there is just a regular Xbox. Then we have four Green Dukes. Those are kind of hard to come by. And then another launch team. This one has not been opened. I have three, two of the three, the one in the box that I was just talking about, this one have not been opened. This is a partner edition. This is the one that they claim there's only 60 of. It has not been opened, and it is mint, just extra good. I was really surprised with how nice that is. For something that rare, you can, beggars can't be choosers. So I'm just ecstatic that that one is as good as it is. And then let's get to. I just have some boxed PlayStation. I never really got into PlayStation. I'm a big Ninja Turtles fan, so I had some Ninja Turtles swag I put up there. Let's see. PlayStation 1 on the left, PlayStation 2 on the right. Games, that is. that's my wife's DS. She doesn't play it anymore, so it got a shelf. The PS1 with the PS1 screen, then the original PS1 on the right. That's actually a 3DO long box, the whatever detective, what does it say? Psychic detective. Okay, and then the Jaguar with its humongous, ridiculous controller. I had a empty shelf, so I got that Hobbit Pez thing for Christmas 1 year, so that got a shelf. The what is that, HD DVD Xbox 360, that got a shelf. Those are kind of uncommon. It was a big flop, so I thought, hey, I better get one of those before they fade into obscurity. The Atari Lynx handheld, I've actually never taken it out of the box, never used it, don't care. I think it looks cool though, and it's got to be somewhat uncommon. Nobody I knew as a kid had one. So anyway, then the PSP and some games for it, the original box that came in and the carrying case. And then below the Xbox 360 HD DVD, that's more 3DO games. That's why I said it's not the most organized thing in the world. Like, the shelves are kind of different sizes, so I just had to put things where they would fit. Two more Nomads that were screen modded. So they have a nice LED backlit LCD screen. Some Pac-Man stuff. I just had another shelf. It's, if you can tell, those are narrower shelves. You just can't fit, you know, DVD cases, normal DVD cases, standing up. And if you lay them down, it leaves a lot of space. It doesn't look right. So I had some Pac-Man stuff. I just filled in that gap with it. And then there's some HD DVDs. They're on the left in the red DVD cases. And then just to the right of there, those are all Xbox 360 games. and then you come down a shelf. Well, the next two shelves, and that's all original Xbox. The two cases to the left there are Xbox Live beta. So after the beta test was over, for Xbox Live, the original beta testers got to, they got sent these cases, and the case says Xbox on it, and it's pretty nice. This one is complete. It has everything that came with it minus one little thing, and I can't unzip it with one hand. Let me get my foot, get my hairy knee. I should have had this done. I just did not think this out. Look over here for a minute. Happy times. Okay, so I have the, it came with the orange memory card. Now, there's like a little keychain holder that fits around the outside of it. If you know anybody that has one of those that's willing to part with it, I'd like to purchase that from them, because that's the only thing this lacks to make it complete. It has all the original headsets, all the original documentation, all the original discs. Which is pretty cool to go through that. Some of the videos I hadn't seen. It's a different version of the videos that are out there. It's all cheesy and stuff, but if you're as into Xbox as I am, it's really cool. And then I've got my debug kits. The one on the bottom, actually, it had the copy of the Halo debug that floats around. You don't have to believe me. It came from that debug, and I released it back in 2002 or 2003 when I first got it, because I'm an idiot. I should have not done that, but anyway, I did that. I traded that. I actually traded that debug executable for the debug kit on top, because I wanted the front panel that said debug kit on it. So, again, you don't have to believe me, but that's actually what happened. Let's see, there's my Halo edition, there's a Crystal edition, there's the Broken Mountain Dew that I was talking about. The black one on the bottom, the only reason that's there is I've had that. That's my original one from when I was a kid. And I modded it, you know, the T-SOP, split T-SOP mod, see the two switches over there? So it has four 256K BIOSes on it. There's just some box, you know, Xbox 360 stuff, the Halo Xbox. Blister packs for the, what is that, a battery and a faceplate, and my Xbox One, that's not in there. That's the only thing probably in this room that's not in there, and the controller, that's downstairs hooked up to the, our main TV. And then we've got, I shot a video with the dev kit that's actually in that box, that came from, where was it? I don't remember. Where the other, where it actually came from, some dev company. And then this one is EA, and it had a beta version of Tiger Woods 2007 and a what is that driving game where you're supposed to wreck? Starts with a C, I think. Doesn't matter. It's not C, it's Burnout. It's one of the Burnout games. And then this came up in the Facebook group. Somebody posted this, and this is the DVD emulator kit. So, hang on a second here. Let me spin this around. Let's see the ports.
So, this port, that actually goes straight to the LPC. So, you, in theory, could debug the kernel with that, you know, the BIOS. This is the, there's a breakout card in here. And so basically the IDE cable comes up, goes to the breakout card, and then that cable would run and go to the hard drive after that. From the breakout card, it has another IDE port that comes down to the DVD drive. So it has some logic in it that tells it, unless this is hooked up, just use the DVD drive as normal. If this is hooked up, go ahead and use this board. The other end of the SCSI cable gets connected to this PCI card. And this would be in your computer. And it has a IDE plug on it. See that? The ATA. Okay, and then there's your SCSI output. So basically what you do is you put, remember, you're developing a game. You mount this ISO, or you mount your game ISO onto this hard drive. It gets loaded through this card, and it spits it out through SCSI. The Xbox receives it, and it's a DVD drive emulator. So that's what's going on. So the Xbox reads your game on the fly. Even though, so it saves you from having to burn a disc and all that. Now, knowing that, that means there's a potential for a hack there, an optical drive emulator. So you could, in theory, have another hard drive there in the place of the DVD drive with an optical drive emulator. And you could, you know, just for instance, put your 007, Mech Assault, Splinter Cell, whatever exploitable game you want, put the ISO on that drive, and then nobody actually needs the game, you know, to mod their Xbox. They can actually download the ISO, put it on their optical drive emulator, and go ahead and mod their Xbox if they so choose. You wouldn't even have to if you were purely a pirate, but none of us are that, right? So we all want the emulators. That's why we do it. So, and then there's another launch team. That one came broken. The hard drive mount, actually, one of the screws had backed out of it, and it was just kind of flopping around in there. It had not made it to the power supply yet. It was just on the motherboard. So they said you could play for a short time, and then it would shut off. So that what that meant was, once it shorted something out, you're done. So when I got it, I didn't power it on. I just shook it, heard the screw, and was like, yeah, I'm not powering that on. So I took it apart. You know, it kind of kills you to do it. Because some people will say that it's not as valuable. Well, to me, it's not as valuable if it doesn't work, if I've blown it up. So I fixed it, modded it up. It has a 1 terabyte hard drive in it, CoinOps, you know, all kinds of stuff on it. Here is N64. It's got the EverDrive, so it's got every game. 2 Conker's Bad Fur Days. A guy basically sold me both of those for $30. One of them had no label. The other one had a damaged label. I left the damaged label on there. That's a repro label because it didn't have one to begin with. So I figure something is better than nothing. But now people are going to think, I can't sell it because people are going to think the whole thing's a repro. That's not. But there's the other label that I got for that one. But I mean, like I said, I'm not going to put it on. But I fixed them both. I found a bad, they had a cold solder joint. Fixed that. A bunch of N64 games in there, a bunch of Nintendo, Super Nintendo. Those are just, since they're unboxed, those are the ones I would play. And then, NES 101 with the original NES 101 dog bone controller. The bottom here is just like mainly Xbox controllers. That's pretty well what that is. There's some Xbox 360 stuff in there, but mainly just Xbox controllers and hookups and, you know, this and that.
This is mainly Genesis cartridges. You can tell I rifled through there. This is mainly Dreamcast stuff. I don't want to really pull that out because it's in disarray. And then that is one. It's all Model 2 Genesis. This is losing my voice here for some reason. That's a Game Gear battery pack, but the battery obviously had long since died in it, and I replaced it with a RC car battery, same voltage, but much more capacity. That thing's been great, and so I just run this Nomad off of it, and it's got the EverDrive, so it's got every 32X, Sega Genesis. And I think Master System game on it. It can only play Master System and Genesis as is. It obviously can't play 32X without the 32X. And then here's my closet. So there's the other Kasumi box. And then there's Game Gear case. Just random items for a play choice. There's a bunch inside that Xbox case. There's a bunch of controllers and hookups and all that. Steering wheel for N64, steering wheel for Xbox 360, just random cables and cords that I've kind of put right there, and wood shelving that came out of this house. And then that is just parts, mainly from Xbox, but you can see there's Dreamcast, N64, Nintendo, Super Nintendo, case, then more Xbox, all the Xbox modding I like to do and all that. Gotta have parts. So there's power supplies, DVD drives, hard drives that you can't see. They're on the back side of that. Just cases. And then these are all pre-mods. They're ready to go. They're just not loaded with the software that people want, which consequently takes the longest. So I really am not ahead of the game by having this here. And on the bottom of them, I've written, what's in Sharpie, what size hard drive they've got, how they're modded, and oftentimes, what DVD drive is in it and if it works. And then, just random items, spare 32X if I had doubles or whatever. Some Atari stuff. Those controllers there, the boxes that you see, those are USB. So basically they're for emulators on the PC. And that's my 3DO. I haven't hooked it up in a while, but it works. It's just, it didn't fit on a shelf anywhere out here, so it's not out here. Power pads. This is all just random boxes of random controllers and just various items for the systems. In some cases, there's Sega CD stuff and other Genesis and whatever. So if I already had it out on display, it'll just stay boxed up. So, but that's my game room. You've seen pretty much all of it. Hope you enjoyed.